Hello friends, today we are going to study structure and unions in C. Now, for today's session, our contents are introduction, declaration of structure, processing of structure, array of structure, passing structure to functions, and unions. Now, before starting the session, I would like to explain objectives of this session. At the end of this session, all of you will be able to explain the concept of structure and union, how the structure and union can be processed, how to pass structure and union to function, and how to make use of structure and or union in real life examples. Now let's start with introduction to structure. We have already studied arrays in our previous sessions. Array is nothing but a data structure whose elements are all of the same data type. Now, in this session, we'll see structure, which is nothing but a data structure again and is a combination of different data elements together. Thus, a single structure might contain integer typed elements or floating point type element or character type elements or of any of the another data type elements. Along with above elements, pointers, any type of arrays and other structures can also be included as elements in a tree structure. Now we'll see how to declare a structure. Half part is declared for the declaration of structure and the remaining half part explains the example of structure. Here, struct keyword is used to declare a structure, followed by the tag, that is name of the structure. Between opening and closing curly brackets, different members of different data types can be declared as member of the structure, and at the end the structure definition ends with a semicolon. Now let's see the example. If student structure we want to declare, it is declared with the struct keyword followed by student as a structure name, where the name of the student is declared as a character string of size 80 characters. The member 2 is roll number of a student of type integer, and a last member is marks are of type float. All members are of different data types. Size of a structure is nothing but the addition of number of bytes required for all members of structure. All these bytes are allotted as in continuous form in the memory. Declaration of structure variable we are going to see now. A structure variable can be declared in following two different ways. A first way is to declare structure variables by defining struct keyword followed by a name of a structure as shown in first example. A struct keyword followed by name of a structure and list of a variable of data type struct. Second way is while defining the structure we can declare a variable. At the time of declaration of structure we can declare its variable at the end of the structure definition. Here, name of structure is optional. Means, if we will not give the name of structure, then also it works with only the variable names. Now, let's go for processing of structure. Here, every member of structure is processed individually. The processing of a structure member is done with the dot operator. With the dot operator, every time a variable is used. That means variable, dot operator and a member name is the correct way for processing of structure. Here, example is explained like s1.name of a student, s1.roll number of a student and s1.marks of a student. Here, name, roll number and marks are nothing but the member of a structure. Here, one reflection spot is like think about the given question and write the correct answer. You can pause this video right now and answer the given questions. Okay, you must be able to give the answer to above all these three questions. We'll move forward for array of structure. Now all of us are knowing the concept of array. Again, array is nothing but a collection of similar data types, and as the array can be collection of similar data types, can we form the array of structure? Yes, obviously we can. So here now we are going to study how to form an array of structure. The declaration of this array of structure is just similar to array declaration. Simple array declaration that may be of type integer, that may be of type character, or that may be of type any data type. Now here struct student is user defined data type, and its variable s is declared as an array of struct student of size 50. Here, variable of structure student is an array of size 50. Other way around, we can say that now this structure is processing 50 students. Accessing of members is same as of the simple array as shown below. S is nothing but the variable name followed by its index, dot operator and the name of the member, like S index dot name, S of index dot roll number or S of index dot marks. Here index will be the same number. Here index will be the number of student of the student structure which you want to access. Now, next factor about structure we are going to study. Passing structure to functions. Structure can be passed by two different ways. Which are the two different ways? Yes, all of us are knowing that two different ways. How the parameters can be passed to function. The first way is pass by value and the second way is pass by reference. In pass by value, value of a structure variable need to pass to function. This is just same as of passing simple variable of any type to function. Scope rules are also same for this type of function call. As whatever changes are made with the structure variable in the called function never reflects in calling function. In the second way, that is pass by reference, reference of structure variable need to pass to function. This is also same as of passing of reference of any variable to the function. Here, as we pass reference of variable, whatever changes are made are gets reflected in the calling function. Again, our next reflection spot. Here, read the question, think on it and write the answer. You can pause this video and answer the question. Okay, now we'll go forward for a last part of our this session. Union. First of all, let's introduce the union. Union is nothing but again a user defined data structure. In comparison with a structure, only a single difference is there. Before that, how the union is a user defined data structure that I am going to explain. As of the structure, union also allows combination of members of different data types. The members that compose a union all share the same storage area within the computer's memory. It's not the case with the structure, and this is the main difference between structures and unions. I repeat, union shares all the memory, union shares the storage area within the computer's memory for all the members which are declared within the union. Is not the case with the structure. In structure, all the members allotted a separate memory. Advantage of a union is, with the use of unions, it conserves the memory. Disadvantage is, as the allotted memory is shared memory, and at the time of single member of a union can be accessed. But we can't access all declared members at the same time as of the structure. Other way around, we can say that at a time a single member of the union can be accessed, but there is no any access is available to all the members at the same moment. If this is the requirement, then we need to use structure only. Now, how to declare the union? Same as of the structure, union is declared. Here, only the difference is that in the keyword. In structure, keyword struct is used, but in case of union, the keyword union is used. Rest of the things are same, where union keyword is followed by the name of union, opening closing curly brackets, ended with a semicolon, and between the number of members are declared. Obviously, that may be of different data types. Following is the example given for a union, where code is the name of a union. Next, two members are there. The first one is color, is of character string. Second one is size of integer data type. Ended with its two variables, they are purse and a belt. Here, an individual union members can be accessed in the same manner as an individual structure members. All rest of the things are same as of the structure. That is, an array of the union we can define. We can pass the variables of union to the function in above two mentioned ways. Again, a reflection spot. Read the question, think and write the answer. Pause this video and answer the question. Thank you.